701-701-#. Again.
*1701#.
*1701#.
*1701#.
Yeah, I mean *1701#.
Yes, sir.
And send it.
Yes.
Have you sent out just come?
They said 1, transfer money.
No,
2,
MoMo pay.
3, airtime and bundle. 4.
Hello. Welcome to my channel once again. Today, I am bringing you something that we in Ghana, or we Ghanaians, mostly joke about these things. And I think it's something serious that I need to prompt anybody, because there are actually a lot of people that are coming to Ghana and they are using Ghanaian SIM cards a lot. So I'm here to prompt you because it's something that they have actually used to scam a lot of people. Yeah, people who are not really inclined when it comes to technology, they've actually used this to defraud a lot of people. This is a fraud, basically. They call you and they are like, they've sent money onto your phone and you have to send the money back to them. Sometimes they just send a normal message. And if you are not someone who is very conversant with some of these things, you might think whatever they are saying is true. So you will send the money back to them if you have the money. But mostly in Ghana, we just play with them. Some of them, when they call, we automatically know that they are fraud. So we joke with them. I will show you some of the videos that mostly Ghanaians just, like when they call, we just joke around with them. But be careful out there if you receive any call like that and someone wants to dupe you or fraud you. Be aware of this particular thing that actually goes on in Ghana. It is done by a lot of people, and I don't know whether it's a particular person or something, I don't know. But mostly they will try to go through with you with a particular process that you should follow that process, and they will get their money back or something. All they are trying to do is to get you a point that they can withdraw money from your account or your mobile money account. So be extra careful. It is even done with your bank account and all that. I have actually received a call from someone who was trying to get me to give him some details. You know, without the details that you are going to give out, they cannot fraud you. So just be careful. Let's go into the video and let me show you some of the videos.
I'm good.
You are very stupid. Why do you let them say block my number? You let them say you are mad. Touch your balance or off your phone for me, eh? You are withdrawing your money. Stupid girl like you. Why do you let them say block my number?
Hello? Huh? What are you saying?
Off your phone. Off your phone. Off your phone. Hello?
Yeah. Hello? Hello? I can't really read it. It's in another like language, in like French or something, like
Okay, but the valid numbers are not correct. Check whether you have a different message. Check whether you have another.
But wait, you said you're calling from MTN?
Yes, madam, MTN. I'm Douglas, thank you.
Okay, but your Douglas entry from which department, please? Because I'm actually also, I also work in MTN, so
This is the mobile money department.
Mobile
MTN
money.
Mobile money. Yeah, at Greater Accra.
At Greater Accra, which brand? Oh,
right.
What's your ID number? Like your working ID number, though?
I'm using an ID number 1228-1A.
Okay.
1228-1A.
Okay, I will. Let me call the head, cause I'm actually, I also work in MTN actually. So, let me just quickly.
What department do you work? What department do you work in?
Like I said, I work with the heads.
The
I don't know.
Things.
Yes.
And you know, right now, this is about the mobile money service, and you know they are using application messages, authorization.
But then okay, so what's going on? Can you throw light on what's happening really on my number, my other number? What's really going on? Please throw more light on that. What's going on? What's happening with it? What's going on?
What is happening here is the authorization messages are taking place on your account. So for
which
that matter, you cannot proceed with your transaction.
No, which authorization? Because I didn't authorize any payments. Do you understand? Like,
no,
I haven't.
The messages are sent by the fraudsters. They are sending a message as approval message. From
yes.
Those are the messages.
But then if I should end up giving out the code, then they have access of it. They are able to take out a loan.
Yes, and the message, listen, and if you are not being able to confirm your code, they can use the message to hack your wallet. So you have your SIM card invalid. That is the problem. You can have your SIM card invalid, and you might not be able to make a withdrawal. You understand me? So we are just trying to delete those authorized messages, and after that, we'll protect your SIM card.
No, if you have not given out your code, they can't get access to your
home. So what?
They can make your SIM invalid. Listen.
How do they have the power to make... But wait, I'm not delaying
you.
But how are they able to make my number invalid if they are not working in MTN? Because it's only the people in MTN that can make a SIM invalid.
Yeah, because they are trying your code. They tried it several times. So when they enter it more than 3 times, that is when you are going to have it invalid.
So let me just call. So then I'm supposed to actually get a call from the fraud center, not you. So let me, okay, just stay on the line. Let me call the fraud center with my other line. Just stay on so that I can just let them know what's going on right now. Just stay on.
Hold on. If you are not interested, you can work to any of the MTN.
No, just stay on. Stay on. Stay on, please. Just don't hang up. Let me call their fraud team. Hold on. Hold on.
Good afternoon.
Afternoon, sir.
How are you doing?
I'm fine. Thank you. And yourself?
By God's grace, I'm blessed. Is it Mr. Inti Prince?
Yes, please.
Yeah, Mr. Prince, you are talking to Mr. Derek Nyaku.
Okay.
I'm calling you from MTN head office, Osu, Accra.
Okay.
Please, MTN, we are celebrating our 30th anniversary promo for some of our great loyal customers on their service.
Okay.
And this very day, your number has been among of our lucky winners.
Okay.
That is why we've called you, Mr.
Okay.
So, Mr. Intini, can you remember the last day you buy credit to your number? And then how much did you recharge?
Okay. My I bought it. Is it 1970?
1970.
Yes.
So please, since you've been on MTN up to date, has MTN awarded you before?
Yes.
What do you want?
Aeroplane.
Pardon me?
Aeroplane.
Jimmy Fuert is awarded.
Where are you born from? Where you born from?
John.
Where you
Your phone has been put
where you born from?
But what is it?
No, yo.
Damn, you mobile money, I'm going to be about life. You take a message, you say, mobile money.
Yeah, yeah.
And I take a phone, I'm going to send a message, you about life.
I'm going to let me a quarter.
Where a quarter?
What's it?
Now, you have to take a phone.
I've been a picking mom.
You've been a picking mom. Do you have a quarter? Many people are picking a phone for phone, man.
Yeah.
Oh.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, let me F1.
F1, la mo ba mo fi.
F1.
F1. What is it?
Bada ko be.
Bada ko ko de chi.
Bada ko ao.
Da bi ti ke fa phone ma bla na ba.
1701# again.
*1701#.
*1701#.
*1701#.
Yes, sir.
And
send it.
Yes. They said 1, transfer money. 2,
MoMo
pay. 3, airtime and bundle. 4. They said, yeah, hello. Yes, the one they said I should transfer money. Okay, the one says that we should transfer money.
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
So please, I'll catch you.
Oh, no, I want to transfer money today. Oh, okay. Okay, I've done one. Yes. They said, number 1, MoMo user. Number 2.
Yes, sir. Hello? Hello?
Hey, Mr. Ennis.
Yes, I was.
Flower catch
Oh, sir.
Now, when I message you from office, also my block mobile money.
I mean, my message on my block. You have been blocked by a MTN office.
So you see, these are some of the things that actually happen in Ghana, and it's just funny for us in Ghana. We just joke about it, but it's actually something serious that you need to be very careful with when you are in Ghana. So that is it. It's just funny.